Dear Daily Fail, what the fuck are you doing? Like, seriously. On the 28th of August, I received two messages from a person going by the name of Isidoro Patalano on both YouTube and Facebook. Now, after a quick Google search, I figured that yes, they were an actual person, and yes, they were part of the Daily Fail team, even though the Facebook message was signed by them but sent to me by another Daily Fail employee by the name of Lisa Snell. The letter read, and I do quote, "Hi Udita, Peter and Ethel, hope you're all well. I am Issy from the Mail Online. We'd like to use your YouTube video," and they gave a link to my YouTube video, "and screen grabs in the Mail Online video player on the Mail Online website, apps, and social accounts. Unless you assign the rights to this video to another company or sign a syndication agreement, we are asking you as the copyright owner for a non-exclusive perpetual worldwide license for your video. This is to include use of the footage and screen grabs in the Mail Online video player on the Mail Online website, apps, and Mail Online social accounts. Please find our terms here," and they gave a link to the form. "We look forward to hearing from you. All the best, Easy." End quote. Now here's the thing. I didn't think I had a legal precedent to withhold copyright, since surely using sections would be covered under fair use for purposes of reporting. I myself had taken the raw 2-minute segment they wanted to use from a 1-hour 80-minute talk uploaded by the transphobic group itself. I took that segment, added subtitles, timestamps, third-party music I'd paid licensing fees for, and most importantly, followed on from said segment with a critique. I had Belos repeat her threat of violence as I displayed a letter in which Belos said threats of violence had no place in debate on that very topic. I took a short snippet and turned it into a transformative piece under fair use law, and would later do the same in a more thorough critique. So had the Daily Fail taken my video and used it for purposes of reporting? I wouldn't have liked it, but I wouldn't have felt I had any sort of grounds to act upon. And this is even though my transformative piece becomes its own copyrighted entity upon its creation. The only grounds I could have seen would have been on the basis of heart. My usage via fair use did not use the quote, heart of the piece, focusing on a rather throwaway segment, whilst the Daily Fail article did seek to use the heart of my video. But even then, I still would have felt like I couldn't have done much. So why am I making this video? Well, what got me about this whole situation was the fact that they sent me the message after they had already published the article, which included a mirror of my subtitled version with the paid-for third-party music, and stills they were requesting the license to do. Not an embedding or a link, a copy. Now, in my original response, I did get it wrong in saying that they sent me the message the day after. This was due to time zone differences. But I had their timestamp on Facebook, which was 3:14 a.m. on the 28th of August, local time to Delhi, which, if you account for the 5.5-hour time difference, meant I was sent the message at 10:44 p.m. on the 27th of August, local time London. This is a bit of a problem for them since the article was published at 10:26 p.m. local time London. Now the math geeks out there will likely tell you that, in the principle of linear time, 10:44 comes after 10:26, not before it. And that's without even considering a reasonable period of allowance, if there is such a ludicrous thing for licensing. Later on, they claim that the video only got added at 1:21 a.m. local time London on the 28th of August. Now, I don't personally trust the people at the Daily Fail, but either way, it's pretty fucking irrelevant. Licensing doesn't work on the basis that if I fail to respond to you in an arbitrary period of time, 2 hours in this instance if they are telling the truth, that's as good as me handing over said license. By that logic, I could send a couple of letters off to large studios such as Disney asking for licensing rights to Marvel Pictures or Star Wars, and if they failed to respond, well, I could reproduce and redistribute however I desired. But even if there was such a ludicrous principle, giving a person less than 24 hours to respond to what amounts to a legal document is a really slimy practice, at least in my opinion. Again, I don't know if I have a legal precedent here due to fair use on reporting. Not that what the Daily Fail does amounts to actual reporting, but I'm speaking in a purely legal sense. Maybe I do and I shall have to check things with a few of my legal associates. It's possible that they do this as a courtesy, in which case it's not very courteous to ask and then go ahead and do so without waiting for a response. Before they got back to me, I had thought perhaps it's something to do with international law. Maybe fair use only cover their UK presence and not everywhere else they wanted to share said piece. However, the later response, an incredibly watery apology, soon proved that not to be the case. The only other alternative I could think of, if I lacked said precedent, is that they were simply covering their backsides to avoid hassle. In which case, much like the courtesy idea, That doesn't really work unless you wait for a response from the person you asked. There's also something I realised in the middle of this, however, and that's the fact that for the first time ever, I am glad a group of people doesn't bother to check their references. If the Daily Fail readership was the sort to do that, the Daily Fail would have created a pipeline between the channel I, a half-Dutch trans person who runs the channel with their Indian partner, founded, and their toxic readership. To any Americans who likely don't understand what I'm talking about, the Daily Fail readership is toxic beyond belief, like truly corrosive. But thankfully, the Daily Fail readership typically lack both the intelligence or the integrity to do so. Anyway, I just wanted to share all that happened in this rather confusing episode. The sudden interest in a video which is over 9 months old comes as a result of Linda Bellos facing private prosecution for incitement to violence. You see, police can make a call on whether to prosecute. However, if they decide not to, possibly due to thinking there's a lack of interest on the matter, a member of said group can decide to prosecute themselves. This is because police are people with flaws, especially when it comes to weighing up the harm minority groups face when people such as Linda Bellos state that they support beating up trans people for simply seeking their rights politically. Not in self-defense, as has been the lie pseudo-feminists have claimed, and if you disagree with me, then please, go see the video with the timestamps and then go watch the whole video and find evidence to support your claims, as I have done so with my own.
Was very, very struck. In fact, I got a note today from a trans woman who I know. I can't remember what she said to me, but something. I said she, because I want to be respectful, that she's very hurt by what I've said. And I asked her a question about race, because it seems to me that one of the categories that human beings, and actually men, came up with the notion of races. The categorization of races seems to have been created around the time of gender being created. And I remain, it's very funny listening to some of the rubbish that's being said about what chaps do, because I must say that having born two children, I think I'm physiologically and in any other senses a female and actually a woman. But I play football and I box. And if any one of those bastards comes anywhere near me, I will take my glasses off and drop them. Anyway, I take my glasses off. I take my glasses off and I leave. I can't see anything. That's not the point. Not that one. It's not the point. But I do, I'm quite prepared to be, to threaten violence because it seems to me that politically, what they're seeking to do is piss on all men. That's what they're doing for their personal gratification. There aren't many of them, but what really offends me is the extent to which academia and political parties have listened to them in a way that they're not listening to us as women. And if any one of those bastards comes anywhere near me, I will take my glasses off and drop them. Anyway, I take my glasses off. I take my glasses off and I leave. I can't see anything. That's not the point. Not that one. It's not the point. But I do. I'm quite prepared to be to threaten violence because it seems to me that politically, what they're seeking to do is piss on all women.
I'm happy that the law is being used here in what is a rather clear case of incitement to violence, and I'm happy that I seem to have played a part in it with archiving video evidence of what Linda Bellos said in full context. If you're going to call for violence against a demographic, you better be ready to face the consequences of your actions. So that was the Daily Fail, a 3-part story in asking permission to use a trans person's video after you've already gone ahead and used it, or failing to wait more than 2 hours for a response at the very least. What the fuck? Hi there. I'd just like to say a few things here at the end of the video before you go. First of all, I'd like to thank everyone who's ever donated to the channel via Patreon, giving a special thanks to the following people: Hannah Banghart, Matthew Kovac, John Schoenrock, Daniel Martinez, and Alexander Williams. Your support has ensured this channel's ability to grow over the years. I'd also like to ask that you comment down below and like this video, as well as subscribe, hit the bell icon, and follow Essence of Thought on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Please also consider following Atheist Alliance International on Facebook, a humanist organisation dedicated to helping atheists around the globe. Any comments utilising language which insults others on the basis of perceived gender, sexuality, ethnicity or ability, both mental and physical, will be removed immediately and the commenter may be blocked on the moderator's discretion. Let's work to keep this space one which upholds the values of humanism. Thank you.